The diencephalon is all things thalamus, and it's part of that deep gray matter that exists within the brain. In this image, we can see our diencephalon right here. It includes the dorsal thalamus, which is this part, and the hypothalamus, which is this part. And you can see that it's continuous with the midbrain of the brainstem. So again, here's our medulla oblongata, and our pons, and our midbrain. The ventral thalamus is off the midline, and so we can't see it in this image. The epithalamus includes the pineal gland and the habenula, and again, they're not really very visible in this particular brain section, and we just don't have time to talk about everything, so we're going to put the epithalamus on the back burner. So within the diencephalon, today we're going to talk about the dorsal thalamus and the hypothalamus. The dorsal thalamus is this area of the brain here and here. It's bilateral. It's connected. You have two thalamic hemispheres connected by a massa intermedia. And the massa intermedia is simply a lump of brain tissue, brain cells, neurons that connect the two halves of the thalamus. We're not going to talk about all 40 nuclei that exist within the dorsal thalamus. We're going to lump them into big functional groups. So the big functional groups of the thalamus are, it participates in the motor system with the basal nuclei. So globus pallidus and putamen and caudate are all going to participate with parts of the dorsal thalamus in that big basal ganglia, basal nuclei, behavioral pattern, motor patterns. It also participates in the limbic system. Certain limbic relays are going to go through the dorsal thalamus. And most importantly, the dorsal thalamus is the gateway to your senses. All of your senses, with the exception of olfaction, are going to go through the dorsal thalamus before they get to cortex. I first want to talk about the sensory nuclei. So if this is our dorsal thalamus here, what I failed to mention in the last slide is there's an intermedullary lamina. So intermedullary lamina. And that's just represented here by this gray line, and it's kind of like it's all the fiber tracts that run within the thalamus to make all of the intrathalamic connections. So they kind of coalesce into this band of fibers that you can see. Two really important nuclei that I want to point out. So if this is our midline, this is our medial geniculate here, and our lateral geniculate over here. The medial geniculate is where all of the information from cranial nerve 8, the vestibular cochlear nerve, goes through the brainstem, and then all that information from the cochlea goes to the medial geniculate nucleus before it goes to areas 41 and 42 of the temporal lobe. The lateral geniculate nucleus here receives information from the retina and information from the retina goes straight through the optic nerve to the LGN and then up to area 17, which is primary visual cortex. And that, of course, is in your occipital lobe. When it comes to other somatosensory information, remember that our ALS system, our anterolateral system, is carrying gross touch and pain. And it travels in parallel with the dorsal column or medial limniscus system. which is fine touch. Okay, all of this information goes into an area called the ventral posterior nucleus. Now there are two subdivisions to the ventral posterior nucleus. There's a medial, and it is getting somatosensory information from above the neck. So what does that mean? That's cranial nerve 5. Remember, cranial nerve 5 is sensory for the oral cavity and the face. So the cranial nerve 5 comes into the brainstem. Its information goes into the ventral posterior nucleus, the medial aspect of it, before it goes up to areas 3, 1, and 2, which is that primary somatosensory cortex. Below the neck, our ALS and gross touch, our ALS system with gross touch and pain, our medial lemniscus system for fine touch, is going to come up and, again, synapse in the ventral posterior nucleus, but in the lateral aspect. So VP, the ventral posterior lateral, is somatosensory below the neck. And I apologize for the fact that all of these silly nuclei within the diencephalon, within the, especially within the thalamus, are named so weird. Ventral posterior medial, ventral posterior lateral. It's complicated, and it makes it a lot harder to learn. But I'm not going to ask you to memorize every single nucleus. So if you abbreviate it, VPM above the neck, VPL below the neck, you'll have the two nuclei, or the nuclei in its subdivision, where all of the sensory information goes through before it goes to cortex. In the next segment, we'll talk about motor and limbic connections of the dorsal thalamus.